Today we'll be taking a look at some stories regarding Sasha Banks, Bray Wyatt, and more. For today's question of the day, who would you book Sasha Banks against for one dream match? More on that story later on. Let's start things off with the latest Bray Wyatt update. There were two images that went viral this week, supposedly of Bray Wyatt. The first picture was a very poor quality picture of what was allegedly a beardless Bray Wyatt with a fan. That picture opened up a debate amongst the fans. Some fans believed it was Bray Wyatt, some thought it was a lookalike, some thought it was a Photoshop picture of Bray Wyatt. We haven't seen a beardless Bray Wyatt in such a long time that fans really had no idea if this picture was real or not. But followed that up a few days later, and another picture of Bray Wyatt goes viral. This time from an audience member in the AEW Rampage crowd that looked exactly like Bray Wyatt. But he had an identical build and even sleeve tattoo going down his right arm. So, from behind or from the side, especially with the face covering on, a lot of nearby fans couldn't tell if this was Bray Wyatt or not. Fans looked at several pictures of the Bray Wyatt lookalike, joking about it with some captions that said things like, "Bray Wyatt in the AEW crowd." As far as everything else goes with Bray Wyatt, he has tweeted out an update picture that many assume to be more early concept art for his next character. The picture fits the usual horror theme that Bray Wyatt is well known for, and seems like it'll be a very scary character for sure. So progress is definitely being made there. Bray Wyatt had the early concept art just a few weeks ago, and now they're already coloring it in, it seems like. Bray Wyatt also took to Twitter to post another quote. He had this to say, "Rock stars come and go. Musicians play until they're gone. Eddie Van Halen." So just a simple tweet about a quote, but wrestling fans just love to dive into everything and try to break it down even more. So if Bray is referring to himself as the musician here, you can basically look at that quote as him saying that he's not going to leave his craft because he left WWE. He's going to continue to do what he loves till the last day, no matter what. So is that what Bray was referring to? Could that be the message there behind that tweet? Hard to tell, but that's a pretty good guess right now. We've seen the big return of CM Punk, how it just took over and went viral for AEW. The build-up for the SummerSlam main event wasn't even getting the type of mainstream coverage and attention that CM Punk's return got alone. It took over, went viral, went into the mainstream media, and now we're all looking forward to that same sort of moment happening again with Daniel Bryan and Bray Wyatt. Daniel Bryan is signed and ready to go. Bray Wyatt is continuing to be highly rumored for AEW. So maybe AEW is the place that we'll see that he's been working on this whole time off since April. That's a whole lot of time for Bray's creative mind to be at work. So his debut will just be as exciting as well with everything he has planned. Brock Lesnar has just shockingly returned to WWE and is now set off to face Roman Reigns. What's funny about this is that Roman Reigns just recently spoke with BT Sport a few days ago. They got into a whole lot of Brock Lesnar related topics. We see Roman Reigns and Paul Heyman together all the time on SmackDown. We even hear Roman's character mention Brock from time to time during the show. Roman has stated several times that even Brock Lesnar's long Universal title reign is nothing compared to his reign right now. Well, Brock is here now. Roman will have to answer for those words. Roman Reigns has this to say when asked about Brock Lesnar prior to his SummerSlam return. "Man, I don't even know. It's hard to speak on Brock. Nobody knows what he is doing. The last I saw, he was butchering cows with a Viking ponytail. So probably Rock at this point. Brock seems like he is out getting his Viking on. So I don't know, man. I haven't heard anything about Brock in a long time. So I would just have to say The Rock." Not only that, Roman Reigns also answered the question everyone has been asking for months, and that's, what will happen with Paul Heyman if Brock Lesnar returns? Brock Lesnar and Paul Heyman didn't end on bad terms, but Heyman is now with Roman. So, Heyman will be put in an awkward position with Roman and Brock facing each other again. Does he stay with Roman Reigns or go back with Brock Lesnar? Roman Reigns had this to say when asked about what Heyman would do. "Come on, his tribal chief? That's who he will choose. Don't be trying to put wedges in. That's history. That's the past, man. I'm moving him forward. Island of relevancy. He won't forget that. So the thought of Heyman leaving him is not even in Roman's head. He's saying that Brock is the past and that he's moving Heyman forward. Heyman won't make that mistake at all in his eyes. So that'll be very interesting to see played out. Maybe Heyman does stay loyal, or maybe it's a good spot to turn Roman face and have Heyman turn on him for Brock Lesnar. But that problem is finally here for Paul Heyman. We'll have to see how he responds. Telling by this interview here, Roman is confident and not even entertaining the thought of Heyman going back over to Brock's side. But if history has taught us anything, it's the fact that you can't trust Paul Heyman. He's a genius. He's a very intelligent character, but he can be slimy and full of schemes as well. What if he was just using Roman Reigns this entire time, just until Brock Lesnar was back? You never know. Could be a possibility. Could have been his plan this entire time. We'll have to see how that story starts to unfold here in the coming weeks. Sasha Banks wants a retired WWE legend to return for one last dream match with her, and that superstar is Trish Stratus. Sasha and Trish actually have history together in WWE. They first came face-to-face several years ago during the 2018 Royal Rumble match, where Trish mocked Sasha Banks. Everyone assumed it was foreshadowing of a future matchup, but it never happened. Trish Stratus wrestled a handful of matches after that Royal Rumble appearance. She was scheduled to face Alexa Bliss at Evolution and later faced Charlotte Flair at SummerSlam before entering retirement again. Sasha was very vocal about her disappointment on the fact that Trish was wrestling on some of the same cards as her, but they never met in the ring. Well, Sasha Banks recently spoke with WWE Deutschland and discussed how Trish Stratus has been dodging her for all these years. "Man, this girl is dodging me. I'm waiting for Trish. I'm ready. I'm here. Whenever she's free and wants to fight the legit boss, the greatest of all time, she can come find me. She knows where I'm at. She has my number. She has Vince's number too." So over 3 years later, after their first on-screen interaction, Sasha is calling out Trish Stratus for this match. Trish Stratus is one of the most legendary WWE superstars of all time. She has nothing left to prove in the ring, but however, if she does have one last match left on the tank, it should be for no one else besides Sasha Banks. You're talking about a match nearly 4 years in the making. It'll be insane if we actually see Sasha Banks versus Trish Stratus one day in the future. So be on the lookout for more comments from Sasha Banks and maybe even a response from Trish Stratus herself. But what are your thoughts on today's stories with Trish Stratus, Roman Reigns, and Bray Wyatt? Leave your comments below. Don't forget to subscribe with all notifications on and leave a like if you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, guys.